श्री जयराम रमेश जी.
थैंक यू मैडम चेयरपर्सन. लेट मी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जॉइन ऑल माय कॉलीग्स इन एक्नॉलेजिंग द डायनामिज्म ऑफ द मिनिस्टर फॉर SMSME. मिस्टर गडकरी इज अ वेरी एक्सपीरियंस्ड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर. ही प्रैक्टिसेस अ वेरी नॉन टॉक्सिक ब्रांड ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स विच मेक्स पॉलिटिक्स एक्सेप्टेबल. He makes, gives everybody a sense of participation and a feeling of consultation. And his appointment as Minister for MSME has brought a fresh air of dynamism into a ministry that is normally not known for dynamism. Let me begin by first saying that Mr. Gadkari is known to speak his mind. He is known to say what is on his mind. And I would like him today to take the House into confidence and really tell us what is the impact of demonetization and GST on the MSME sector. I believe GST was a major reform. It was badly needed. And I congratulate the government for bringing in GST. However, the manner in which GST was implemented, the hurry with which it was implemented, has adversely affected the MSME sector particularly. I have no problem if you want to formalize an informal economy. That is a worthwhile objective. However, the fact is that the double shock of demonetization in November 2016 and GST in July of 2017 has created major, major dislocation in the MSME sector. You can go to any cluster. You can go to Tirupur. You can go to Avadi. You can go to Jalandhar. You can go to Ludhiana. You can go to Pune. You can go to Aligarh. You can go to Howrah. You take any of the sector clusters in India and you will see the impact of GST and demonetization. And therefore, I request the Honorable Minister, let us now, demonetization is a reality. GST is a reality. Let us look ahead. What are you doing to enable the MSME sector to overcome the shocks of demonetization and GST? Please do not tell us that they were not shocks. They were shocks. One was a welcome shock, one was an unwelcome shock. But what are we doing to strengthen the MSMEs to deal with the fallout and implications of demonetization and GST is my first question to the Honorable Minister. My second point to the Honorable Minister, I think it's time we change the definition of MSMEs. For many years, I have been arguing India is the only country in the world which defines MSME on the basis of investment and plant and machinery. And I have been arguing that we should define MSME in terms of employment, because employment is the biggest challenge that India faces. However, after GST, I have changed my mind. And I believe that there is merit in defining GST on the basis of turnover, not necessarily employment. For this, the MSME Act of 2006 needs to be amended. And I would like the Honorable MSME Minister to enlighten us whether there is any plan for changing the definition of MSMEs, because if you define MSME in terms of turnover, compatibility with the GST and GSTN becomes easier, because the entire GSTN information backbone is based on turnover, is not based on capital employed. So the amendment to the MSME Act, because we passed an MSME Act in 2006, which defines MSME in terms of capital employed, I would request the Honorable MSME Minister to educate us on this aspect. The third point I would like some enlightenment on is we have passed the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. But the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code has little meaning for the MSME sector. It is of relevance for the large organized sector of industry. But for the MSME sector, as I have argued repeatedly on earlier occasions, we need a completely new mechanism for insolvency and bankruptcy, which is a major issue as far as the MSME is concerned. This too, I think, will require amendments, not to the IBC, but amendments to the MSME Act of 2006. And I would like the Honorable Minister to make a few comments on this. Then, Madam, delayed payments is the single biggest problem for the MSME sector. In 1993, Parliament passed a Delayed Payments Act. Under the Delayed Payments Act, 90 days is the maximum period given for liquidating all payments for the MSME sector. But we know, and anybody who has dealt with the MSME sector knows, that payments are not made on time. And the biggest culprits are public sector companies and government departments. And I would like the Honorable Minister to tell us what he is doing to enforce the Delayed Payments Act in letter and spirit, so that one cause of sickness in the small and medium sector is obliterated and eliminated. Then I ask him a question on cluster development. India has over 150 industrial clusters. In fact, you have clusters in every state. They are specialized clusters, and some of them are generalized clusters. But the characteristic of MSME is a cluster. And your state of Maharashtra is the best example of a cluster. Thana Belapur is a cluster. Pimpri Chinchwad is a cluster. Aurangabad is a cluster. Nagpur is now emerging as a cluster. So what are we doing for cluster development? Because cluster development requires infrastructure. Cluster development requires technology. Cluster development requires finance. The whole future of the MSME sector depends on cluster development. And instead of having smart cities, in my view, we should have smart clusters. The first target for smart cities should be MSME clusters. And I would like the Honorable MSME Minister to take this idea forward. Finally, Madam, KVIC and traditional industry is very much part of the mandate of the MSME Ministry. KVIC is a statutory body by an Act of Parliament. I think the time has come to corporatize KVIC. We need to professionalize KVIC. We need to bring modern management, modern finance, modern marketing into KVIC. The old 1956 model of KVIC, in my view, has outlived its utility, and we need to think bold. And this minister is known to think boldly, if not some always realistically, but I think in this matter, he would be doing the nation a great service if he were to give a new future and direction to KVIC and traditional industry. We had, in 2005, started a scheme called Sfurti, the scheme for the fund for the upgradation of revival of traditional industry. Mr. Alphonse is here. One of the objectives of the scheme was to revive the coir industry in Kerala. There were many industries, handlooms industry, handicraft industry, coir industry, and this Sfurti scheme was launched in a major way to revive traditional industry, because this is important from the point of view of exports, it's important from the point of view of employment as well. And I would like the Honorable Minister to enlighten us and educate us as to what he is doing in this area. Finally, sir, many members have spoken of the UK Sinha Committee report that was submitted to the RBI in 2019. Could you tell us what you are doing by way of implementation of the recommendations of the UK Sinha Committee? Have you accepted those recommendations? Because in my view, it is one of the most comprehensive reports for the revival of further growth of the MSME sector. And I think the country will benefit if the recommendations of the UK Sinha Committee, which go all the way across the board, are implemented seriously by the government. With these few words, I would once again say that the MSME sector is fundamental to economic growth in India. It requires constant push. I believe the minister is in a position to give this push, but to give the push, it has to recover from the two shocks that were given to it in 2016 and 2017. And unless that recovery takes place, I'm afraid we are not going to move very far in the MSME sector. Thank you, Madam.
Shri Ram Vicharnetam ji.